despite the fact that we know so much about genetics. We know that genomics is the foundation of biological traits. We kind of still have a hard time to understand which change in the genome is kind of responsible to the different variation of traits. And just like bringing an evolutionary perspective to it is an alternative approach to bridge the link between genetic variation and traits. My laboratory is actually a lab of ancient DNA. Our biological characteristic is encoded in our DNA. All animals have the capacity of editing their DNA from one generation to the other. And those edits could lead to the emergence of a new trait, of a new variation of a trait. What my lab is doing is, instead of just relying on present-day genomics and inferring the past, I go directly in the past. I try to extract DNA from fossil remains and sequence, and that gets a proper direct evidence of what was the genomics of past human individuals, the biology of those past individuals, and then I can also compare to how it changed, how it differs from us today. As you can imagine, like, working with ancient DNA is not trivial, because after the death of an organism, then the nature sets everything to disappear. For the DNA to survive, you need to have like specific condition, and the DNA that we're actually going to retrieve are highly degraded. What we retrieve, we extract of DNA, it's a bunch of small fragments, and to reconstruct a genomic sequence, we are going to align them to a reference genome and try to reconstruct the genomic sequence of those past individuals, like doing a puzzle. So that's why we are working in clean room, which is a high pressure, high confinement room that prevents the material to be contaminated by environmental DNA. Every single ancient remain samples is different. The amount of fragmentation will be different. The amount of DNA preserved will be different. The amount of damage will be different. So we have to adapt almost to every single sample our protocols. To understand who we are, where we are coming from, how we emerge. I think we are all very interested into those type of questions. We know how an environment changed in the past and what it made to us. So we can kind of like infer future prospects of environmental change, how that will impact us. We're also very interested into, of course, health. By putting health in a historical perspective, and understand the different genomic signature associated with past pandemic and things like that can also inform future public health strategy, kind of make inference also about our future.